Hello everyone, today I will speak to you about something simple but yet very important. I'm talking about key value databases and specifically how we will use a very simple one I have made with one class using properties class in Java. So let me explain you what it is a key value database and why we need it. Imagine that we have an application, all right, and you want to save settings, the settings for this application. So let me check. Okay, so you want to save the settings of that application. One user is using it. His name may be George or something other. He has some favorite items. She's wearing some t-shirts that have a specific color. Examples. So here it is the name. His name might be George. The key value databases have two columns. One column is for the key and one column is for the value. So his name might be George. His favorite items might be chocolate, computers, and clothes, all separated by comma or something other as a character. And maybe his wife is named Lila and things like that. How you save them to your application? Well, you can use this way. So let's go in our Eclipse. I have made a special class right here called PropertiesDB. The PropertiesDB is doing exactly that thing, creating a file and where you can store your settings as key and value pairs. So I will create a class and name it example, and I want a public static void main to be created automatically. So I am right here. I will create my application. So I want the database, create key value database. So properties DB, properties DB is new properties DB. Now I will give the absolute path of the file, the file that will store the key value pairs. So I will name it settings.properties, and this value will be false by default. I will explain you what it is, the other value. So properties is properties db.loadProperties. We want to load the properties because if we have already created the database file from before, we want to load that properties so we can retrieve them. All right, okay, so look how I will save the data. I will do properties db.updateProperty name, and I will give George. Properties db.updateProperty its wife, and we'll name it Lila. Very well, so simple. Look now, I will run it. I'm running it, and guess what? It has created our database, key value DB. So here it is. His name is George, and his wife is Lila. Let me check the time here, 4 minutes. Well, so now we have saved the settings for our application. How we retrieve them? We go here and I will comment these lines because we have saved the settings and we have done the same thing. We create the database. Actually, the database is just a file, just a file. So here we are loading the properties. Here it is. Why we need to load the properties. You see, I here load the properties. Properties. Because now we will retrieve the data. So, properties dot get. No, it's not like that. Okay. So we need to do properties DB dot get. How we actually do that? Yes, it is properties dot get property, and now we need the name of the key we were using. So we want the property name. All right. Dot get. So we have retrieved it. We took that property and it is returning to us the value. So let's print it. System.out.println and the property right here. So I will run it, and guess what? We have George. All right, I will cut the video right here and I will continue with the next tutorial.